I definitely was not perfect. I did some things wrong.
Do you have any regrets about how you handled the season? You kind of hinted at maybe with your using absolutes. Would you say maybe that was something you would go back and do differently, or you just learned from it?
Yeah, you know, I think for me, I realized that I'm like, I can't say that I have any regrets, because if I would have done things differently, would it have been my 100% authentic journey? And I think the answer to that's no. So what I did in every moment while I was there was what I thought was right. Does that mean it was right? Probably not, no. I mean, I definitely was not perfect. I did some things wrong, but I did everything under my own volition and what I thought was best. And so for that, I'm like, you know what? You stayed true to yourself. And you know, you develop some battle scars along the way, but that's just what life is.
Another clip that's kind of making a lot of getting a lot of attention is the question of, has anyone ever taken a rose back before? Can you tease to me anything about what goes down there?
I will just say that obviously, yeah, I mean, I said that because that thought crossed my mind. Now, whether or not I acted upon it, you know, that's what everyone's gonna have to wait and see. But there were many moments throughout the journey where I was shocked, and I was just kind of, yeah, asking Jesse sometimes these questions of like, is this something that I can do? Because this is how I feel. I mean, this is what, I mean, ultimately I was just navigating my love journey the way that I felt was right.
You mentioned Jesse, it's been a minute since he handed out roses, but he has before. What was the best piece of advice he gave you? How did you guys get along?
Well, Jesse and I got along. I mean, so great. I keep telling everybody, like, we're like brothers. We really are. We're constantly texting each other, just checking in. You know, he's somebody that, because we have very similar backgrounds, he resonated with me very quickly. And I think the biggest thing he told me was just stay true to yourself. And it's not this mind-blowing advice, but it was so relevant. It's like, don't try to be anybody else. Just do this the way that you think is right. And at the end of it all, you'll be thankful that you did. And you can't really hold, you know, you can't have any regrets at that point if you are just who you try to, you know, just be yourself all the way through. So that was, I mean, he gave me a lot of advice, but that was obviously the most, you know, the one that I took to heart and realized I had to stick with.
And then, you know, obviously this season, it came out a little differently of people finding out you were The Bachelor before we even met you on Michelle's season. What would you tell critics who maybe were questioning why you got the gig, and what can they look forward to?
You know, I think, yeah, everybody has a lot of questions, right? And rightfully so. I've read everything online, so I know what's being said. You know, people saying, oh, he, you know, we don't know his personality. And so why did he get picked? And, you know, I will say this, like, I will get a little bit more airtime, I think it's safe to say, on my side of things here. So my personality will come out. And I think people will see it for what it is. And I'm excited. I just ask that people obviously be patient and give me that shot. But I know that, again, I don't know all the reasons why I was chosen, but I can say that, again, I think the producers saw me as someone who really was wanting to find love. And so they're like, you know, this is somebody that, again, like, we believe in, that's here to, like, take this seriously. And I did. So I was just so very thankful to be offered the position to be The Bachelor.